Hello everyone, welcome to Learn and Grow with Synergy. With this initiative, we would like to help and enrich every homeopath's experience of using the programs as well as learning and growing with the Synergy homeopathic software. In this video, we will teach you how to use reference works, how to solve simple to complex cases using reference works. So the best way to demonstrate this is with the help of cases. So the first case I would like to share is a case of a 27-year-old executive, and he comes with the complaints of pain in the heels. He says the pain is unbearable. Every morning, I cannot touch my feet to the ground. On asking further to describe his complaint, he says, "I have needle-like pain in the heel, and it isn't more in the morning when I get up. I work throughout the day, I walk, I have a lot of exertion, but there is little or less pain. But in the morning, it is really unbearable." So now comes the big question, what to do, whether to search and scan the entire Materia Medica available with us for this symptom or search in the best possible repertory for it, and how to do. So normally what we are used to do always is that we take a symptom, we search in the best possible repertory, we locate a particular chapter, and with the help of a rubric or sub-rubric, we are able to find the best possible expression of the patient. But there is a very, very simple, easy, and flexible way to a case, and that is with the help of reference works, which I will show you now. So in this case, we have three things. One is the morning time modality, the needle-like pain, which is the sensation feeling, and the location, which is heel. So we open reference works. So this is how it opens up. And there is a tool palette over here, which is called. Once you click this tool palette, the hand over the tool palette, it opens up the phrases window, which helps you perform searches with whatever words you intend to search, depending upon the case at hand. So here we put just the key words of the patient, which are essential for us to get an answer from the entire library of our books. And I type over here, morning, and then press the number 3, and then the word needle. So you can see when my word is red over here, it means that there are no references of this particular word. It is not the right perfect word. So many a times, whenever you are performing a search, this word may become red. So it indicates that you need to craft a word which is having its presence in the library. And once I press needles, yes, now it is black. So it helps us also guide to take the best word. And then the third word which we have to put is the location. So I press the number 3 and I put heel. And now I want the program to search for morning within 3 words of needles within 3 words of heel. Why 3 words? This will be explained when we have the result from this search. So I press enter on a Windows computer and return on the MacBook Macintosh. And once I click over here, clipboard opens up on the right of my phrases window, and it says morning within 3 words of needle within 3 words of heel. and there is only one remedy, which is Bryonia. Now, how to read the reference of Bryonia? Which book is having it? So I go to this particular window, which is the references window, and once I click over here, I see that my reference has come from a particular book. Which book? I just roll over my cursor and I come to know that it is mentioned in Hahnemann's Materia Medica Pura. You'll be able to read in this location once I roll over my cursor over this book. And this is the reference string which opens up. So there are three references for this particular remedy, Bryonia. Once I click over any reference string, it opens up exactly at the location where it is present in my source book. And it's written over here, in the morning, in bed, needle pricks in both heels, which went off after rising. Very interesting. Now you can see, in between morning and needle, there is a word bed. In between needle and the word heel, there are two words, pricks and both. The in is a small word which is never considered. So the program has used your connector three word, and yet it has made a search which omits the words which are present in between the words intended to search. And this is the best part of the program. It gives you exact precision, the way you want it in a case and the way it is present in the source books. So this case improved with Bryonia. Now there are many more connectors in the program which I would like to share with you. It's called as shortcuts. So you don't have to manually go and type sometimes. You can just use a shortcut key. So for using the words 1 word to 9 word, you use the numeric key 1, 2, 3, 4 to 9 respectively. And then there are other connectors which are same sentence, for which we press the space bar twice. Same paragraph, for which we press the space bar 3 times. Same section, for which we press the space bar 4 times. And same remedy, for which we press the space bar 5 times. Well, at once it is difficult to remember, but as you keep on performing searches, you will be able to easily remember it. And the ease of using it is really the best part of this program. So now, how to use these different connectors and when to use? We'll go over to the next case. And this is a case of constipation after fright. It's a case of a girl, aged 11 year old. And she was passing through a dark street when suddenly she sensed some noise and got frightened. She developed abdominal pain 2 hours after the incident. And by the next day, lot of urging to stool. Frequently she has to go, but there was constipation. Now, normally what we are used to do, as I said earlier, we repertorize the case. So when we see the repertory, there are two rubrics, one in the mind, which is fear, fright, after, and another, rectum, constipation, urging, with constant desire, fear, fright, shock, after. Opium was given, but it did not help. Now, it may happen so in many cases where we repertorize and we may get stuck up. What to do further? The best part with us is using the reference works. So we go to reference works and we remove the search which is present already by using a backspace from the phrases window. And here I type just the keywords in the case which I know are really, really important. So I type fright, F-R-I-G-H-T. And now I press the spacebar twice, so I get same sentence. Then I press urging, Then I press the number 3. Then I press the word stool. And then the word frequent. So what I'm telling the program to search is, search for fright. And also in the same sentence, search for urging stool frequent. Because if I search in a same paragraph or a same section or a same remedy, it may be too far. Currently, I want in this case where it should be exactly closer to the next words, yet in the same sentence. So you have the precision what you want in the case. And this is with the help of reference works. So once you press enter, it shows you a particular search which has come up in a next window in the clipboard. And over here, you see that it is written fright in the same sentence as urging, within 3 words of stool, within 3 words of frequent, and the only remedy is aconite. Well, I was also surprised. So I went over to open the reference window here, and once I see over here, I see that there is mentioned by Herring Condensed Materia Medica and Pulford's Aconitum. So I just click on any book, say Herring Condensed Materia Medica, and I click over here, and I can see it's written cutting, griping, followed by frequent urging to stool after anger or fright, exactly as it was present in the patient and it was seen in my source book. With aconite, this child improved a lot. So you can see, performing and using various searches with its ease and with the fastness, the lightning fast search, will help you take to another level in your homeopathic practice. So this was about this case where aconite was given. So this is the path breaking tool reference works, which is the next level of homeopathy, which is just a revolutionary tool. Now the last case which I have is a case of cervical spondylosis. A computer operator comes with complaints of pain in upper back, has been diagnosed cervical spondylosis by orthopedics. He says he is quite normal when working on a computer, but while he has to write anything, to sign documents and do a pen work, he has trouble doing it. Also, he says he has strong desire for pickles. In the mind aspect, there was not much he could share. So what we can do over here is, he constantly kept on telling that he cannot hold his pen with his hand, and there is no pain, no numbness, or even if there is, it's quite common in cases of cervical spondylosis. So now we have to search for best possible expression of this patient from our entire literature. And what we can do is, by going in the reference works, we remove the previous search and just type what is essential in this case. So I go over here and I type finger, 3, hold, 3, cannot. So you can see I missed the word letter number 3, and it is showing me that this word is nothing, not present. I can read over here, no references. Right click this word for alternatives. So I missed out the number 3. I can just go back, press the number 3 and continue with my search. And now I want to search the symptom of patient which is presented another sphere, which is a desire. So I use the connector in the same remedy, which is by pressing the spacebar 5 times. These shortcuts are really helpful and really quick. With the help of these shortcuts, you can access whatever searches you need to perform instantly. And now I type the other word, which is pickles, and 3 words, desire. So I can now tell the program to search for something which is exactly specific in this case. These are two symptoms which are united by a connector in the same remedy. And I want to put it in another clipboard because the previous one is full. So I just go over here on the right hand side window and I select the B clipboard, which is empty. I close the other windows. And now once I press enter, I get only one remedy, which is Natromul. Very interesting. What is the reference for finger hold cannot? I wanted to know. And once I click the reference thing over here, I can see something mentioned in Henry Sainé's repertory edition about Pickle's Desire, and the second from Hughes' Cyclopedia. We will read it. So I just click over here in this Hughes' Cyclopedia, the word where I wanted to read, and it opens up over here. Trembling of fingers, she cannot hold anything fast in the hand or even close it. Exactly as the patient told me, and the other search was very, very clear. So now I want to read the previous search, which is present over here on the top, just above Hughes. So I just press the button shift and tab, which takes me to the previous search. So here I have shift and tab, and I go to the previous search, which is food and drinks, Pickle's Desires. And now I press the button tab. So I go to the next consecutive search, which is in the Hughes' Cyclopedia. So with this ease of using these shortcuts, it's very, very flexible for me to go in any book and come out of any book and perform searches with much more flexibility. So in this case, Natromul helped this patient a lot, and he could resume his work and also have reduced complaints of his pathology. So the best part is that I have best of both the worlds, the old as well as the new, the contemporary authors, the source books, the provings, the Materia Medicas, as well as the latest additions from Andre Sainé's to Dr. Sankaran to Dr. Massimo Mangialavori, and anything and everything, you name it. So in this case, you saw Natrum 200 was given, and this is what we are used to do, and we'll be used to doing is we'll continue to help and support, advance your homeopathy and improve your prescription and grow your practice. Thank you.